see one before you hit the button. Hi everybody, happy Thanksgiving. All right, today is Thanksgiving and I'm going to make my creamed corn that I like. I make roasted creamed corn. First, I cream my own canned. I like to use kind of a premium corn because you're less likely to get bits of the cob in it. So what I do is I use a hand blender and I chop it up, and to it you're going to be using, I like to use a little bit of heavy cream, a little half and half. I get the roasted cream corn. You can roast your own, I'm sure, but I get this stuff at Trader Joe's. And you're going to be using either Parmesan or what I like to use, which is a Pecorino Romano cheese in it. And all of it goes into my electric skillet where I'll heat it up, and I'll show you it from that point. Okay, once you get the cream corn that you've made in, put about 2 tablespoons of butter. You start to heat it through, and it starts to get real nice and hot and everything. You add, I like to add about 1/4 cup of heavy cream and start mixing that into it. This doesn't really take that all that long to make, as you can see. Probably the longest part will be grating the cheese. Then I add the roasted corn to it. See the nice color that has? And it gives it a real nice taste. And this is going to heat through. And then I'm going to be adding some seasonings, which I will be showing you in a few minutes. Let me let this heat through. Okay, now after it's heated all the way through, I've added about, probably about another 1/4 cup of the cream. And now you add about a cup, maybe a little less, you can add about 3/4 cup of the Romano or Parmigiano cheese. The rest of this will go on top of it where I will be sticking it in the broiler. And you get this all incorporated. You want to get it started melting. I got this recipe kind of from taste and trial, and I added the roasted corn to it. I used to make it without the roasted corn until I found roasted corn one day in the store. I got this by going to Hoss Hut, had the best cream corn I'd ever had. And I fell in love with it, and so I had to make it myself at home. Now I add a little bit of nutmeg. And this cute, it's a grater. I add a little bit of nutmeg, which I usually do to any cheese sauce dish that I use Italian cheese in. It just adds a nice flavor to it. So you add a little bit of nutmeg, get that stirred in. It just kind of enhances the cheese flavor. It doesn't really taste like, ooh, nutmeg, you know, like you're eating pumpkin pie or a donut or something. Get that stirred in. And then the other thing I like to add is a smoked paprika. Not only does it add a nice color, but it adds another smoky depth to it. I love the smell of this stuff. And I add probably about a teaspoon of that, because it really boosts the flavor. And like I said, it adds a nice coloring to it, because I love the color of paprika, but you know, dark orange, orangish browns are my favorite color anyways. So this goes in, all stirred in. All right, and next I will be showing it after I put it into the tin before I stick it in the oven. Okay, now I got it inside of the container, which I'm going to be cooking it in. At this point, I put more cheese on top. Now, I didn't put any salt into this dish. The cheese is plenty salty. And I don't really want to make it overly salty because it's not the best for your health or heart, which we all know everybody can have issues with that. Nobody's immune to it in this world. And then I like to just give a light sprinkling of paprika on top for coloring again. And this is going to go under my broiler. So until it gets nice and brown and all bubbly on top, and that's it. And as Julia Child would say, bon appetit. And I wish you all a happy Thanksgiving. This also goes very well with just about anything, any time of year. My children love it when I make a glazed pork roast, roasted chicken. It's really good with pork. So that's it. Bye.